There are a number of different correlations for free convection depending on the flow regime and the geometry of the object. So in this screencast, we'll look at free convection over a horizontal plate. So when I talk about correlations, what I'm actually looking at is a correlation for the Nusselt number, which is equal to H times L, which is some characteristic length, divided by K, which is the thermal conductivity of the fluid. So this Nusselt number is usually a function of the Rayleigh number as well as the Prandtl number. So our goal is to find the appropriate correlation for the Nusselt number, thereby being able to solve for H. And from there, we can use Newton's law of cooling that says Q, or the heat transfer rate, is equal to this heat transfer coefficient times the cross-sectional area times some delta T. And in free convection, that delta T is going to equal T of the surface minus the temperature of the ambient air. Free convection flow over a horizontal plate does not have just one correlation for the Nusselt number. We have four different possibilities. So the first thing we have is a plate whose temperature is higher, its T surface is greater than T infinity. And we call this a heated plate. When we're looking at free convection over a heated plate, we have two possibilities as well. We have from the upper surface as well as the lower surface. In addition, we can have what's known as a cooled plate. So this is when T surface is less than T infinity. And again, it has different correlations for both the upper and lower surface. The reason you have this is that the physical phenomena that's occurring is due to the top surface of a cooled plate or the bottom surface of a heated plate will impede the flow of the fluid since the flow must move horizontally before it can ascend or descend from the edges of the plates. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the same conditions that we used for a previous screencast that looked at a vertical plate with free convection. So we're going to look at both surfaces of a heated plate. And so on the heated plate, the surface temperature is 90 degrees C, and the ambient temperature is 25 degrees C. Now, as I mentioned before in screencasts, the dimensionless parameter that guides free convection is what's known as the Rayleigh number. So, some of the properties that we're going to have to look up include the kinematic viscosity, as well as the thermal diffusivity and the thermal expansion coefficient. And in order to look these up, we have to have the right temperature. And so what we use for these correlations is the film temperature, which is just the average or TS plus T infinity divided by 2 in Kelvin. And so our film temperature for this particular situation is approximately 330 K. So let's go ahead and look up all these properties, as well as this property RK, which again is the thermal conductivity of the fluid. If you notice, these are exactly the same properties as we used in our previous screencast about vertical plates. So you'd think that the Rayleigh numbers would be exactly the same. However, for horizontal plates, it's suggested that our characteristic length, that L, should be the surface area of the plate divided by its perimeter. So we'll end up calculating that, so that L is going to equal 0.3 meters times 0.6 meters divided by our perimeter, which is 2 times 0.3 meters plus 2 times 0.6 meters. And just to refresh your memory, or just in case you didn't see the vertical plate, what we've done is taken a plate that's 0.6 meters high and 0.3 meters wide and basically flipped it over to make it into a horizontal plate. And so when we look at this length, it's equal to 0.1 meter. For a vertical plate, the characteristic length is the height of the plate, which in that case was equal to 0.6 meters. Now, let's go back and put all of these values into our Rayleigh number. And what we do, we end up with a Rayleigh number that's equal to 3.055 times 10 to the sixth. Now that we have our Rayleigh number, we can decide what correlations to use. For our upper surface, the correlation for the Nusselt number is equal to 0.54 Rayleigh to the 1/4, which equals 22.6. If we look at the lower surface, the appropriate correlation is 0.27 Rayleigh to the 1/4, which is equal to, as you could probably figure out, 11.3. So notice the difference that the impediment of the plate makes to the bottom surface, showing the effect of the horizontal flow. So then we go ahead and we calculate our H, which is equal to our Nusselt number times our K divided by, and again, this is our characteristic length. We find that the H of the upper plate is equal to 6.78, and the H of the lower plate is equal to 3.39. And again, the bars over there show that it is an average heat transfer coefficient. So the heat transfer rates are, again, the same that the upper plate, 79.3 watts, is twice that of the lower plate, which is 39.7 watts. In comparison, our vertical plate had a heat transfer rate of 48.6 watts. So why is this? Well, since a vertical plate is the same direction as gravity, fluid motion is caused only by buoyancy. For the lower surface of a heated plate, there's a reduction in buoyancy, which then decreases the heat transfer. However, for the upper surface, heat transfer is enhanced by the three-dimensional flow that occurs due to boundary layer displacement. Therefore, we would expect to have this order of heat transfer rates, where the upper plate has the highest heat transfer rate, the lower of the horizontal plate has the lowest, and that vertical plate is in between.